the dark side of living in Britain. If you're contemplating moving to Britain to escape poverty, for education, for career advancement, or to raise a family, think twice before you hop on the train. There are dark sides of living in Britain that you need to consider closely. When people arrive in Britain in search of a greener pasture, they're rudely shocked by those dark sides. Today, I'm going to show you some of them. They're actually among the reasons why foreigners who intend to live in Britain don't stay. I need to quickly tell you this. The listing here represents just my personal opinion, and some might consider it a plus and not a minus. Number 1. The cost of living is high. There's no arguing this point, especially if you're living in London and other high-end cities in Britain. What you spend mostly on accommodation is a dark side of living in Britain. Rent is astronomically huge. Even outside those cities, rent generally gulps a large chunk of your earning, compared to the cost of living elsewhere in Europe. You're made to feel you're in the UK to work simply to get a place to lay your head. Number 2. The weather is unstable. If you have to plan your days and weeks based on weather forecasts, think twice before you start to live in Britain. The weather is pretty unstable. It rains a lot in Britain. For some people, it's not a problem, especially those who were born and bred in the UK. For those who move in from other countries, the weather is something else. You can't rely on it. However, as you advance southwards, you find that you get less rain, and it usually gets warmer. Even then, when you're going out, please don't forget your brolly, is the popular saying. Well, this is the dark side of living in Britain. Number 3. Binge drinking. British drink a lot if they can afford it, and almost everyone can afford to binge. There's a dangerous culture among university students called pre-drink. This means they drink a lot of alcohol before they go out partying. This doesn't prevent them from taking more drinks at those parties. But the basic idea is that they drink to the point of getting drunk so that they'll have a front for not drinking a lot more when they get there. They had to drink such that it will be obvious that they're drunk. That takes off the pressure to pay for more expensive drinks at their party. For other people, this might even be a pro rather than a con, an invitation to go to the UK. Let's go there and drink. It may also be excused that those binge drinkers are preserving the British thriftiness tradition while partying nicely. But this is not limited to youth. Adults do it too. Imagine going on a lunch break and having a beer or two. The drinking culture here is quite permissive, but it's not going to be a dark side for the alcoholics. Number 5. Salaries are poor. How much would you consider an ideal salary? It depends on where you work vis-a-vis where you live. And we aren't dealing with figures now, oh no, not today. But why are most people using cheap and small cars? The fact is that most people living in Britain struggle to survive. The dark side of living in that country is that the salary is too poor to make you rich. Number 6. British foods are unseasoned. Not everyone will agree with this, but it is to many a dark side of living in Britain. If you have a background similar to mine, you would see British foods as bland. You may be surprised that some Britons don't add salt to their rice or noodles. Some people consider those foods underseasoned, while it's cool for some. But there are many good restaurants where foods are adequately spiced, and there are places where you can eat continental foods. Number 7. Britons are very reserved. That's the English heritage. Britons are polite and are naturally reserved. Each one makes conscious efforts to avoid offending the next person. That politeness makes them avoid meddling in other people's affairs. However, what is considered meddlesomeness might actually lead to boredom for many. This is a dark side of living in Britain. Imagine your neighbor not caring about how you're doing and not being available to help in case of an emergency. This can make living in Britain so boring, less social. Number 8. It's difficult to find friends in Britain. Consequent to the point just mentioned, you'll find it difficult to make friends in Britain. It'll take a while. Remember, these people are reserved and over-polite. It's difficult to develop relationships and to deepen the existing ones. The dark side of living in Britain, if you're not a Briton, is that people don't easily open their hearts to strangers. It's a culture shock to many from places where people love to engage strangers in conversation straight away. Britons may be nice at first and talk to you for the first few seconds or so. After the small talk for a couple of minutes, they start to turn away, as if they're telling you, "Hey, it's time to go, I've had enough of this conversation." We can't build a relationship easily. So if you just come as an expat or a student, you should be prepared for that dark side. Number 9. Houses are very small. If you're used to living in a semi-detached duplex or a house with a palatial living room and bedrooms with big beds and more space, hey, you aren't going to get that in Britain. The houses are too small. Britons generally don't live in big houses. No, no, not here. This is a dark side of living in Great Britain. Small houses automatically get small entrances leading to rooms which should automatically have small doors. You'd better cut down on your weight as you can't live comfortably in those small rooms in Britain if you're big. You'll love this nevertheless. The smaller the rooms, the cheaper it is to heat them. Number 10. Roads are small. I wonder why anyone would be surprised upon entering a room in Britain and realizing that those rooms are small. Haven't you passed through roads before getting to the small houses and rooms? How wide are the roads? Haha, there you are! Roads are just too small in Britain, and that is another dark side. That's why you can't automatically get a driver's license in Britain no matter how long you've been driving your country. It's not just because you drive from the left, you also have to learn to drive on narrower roads. They are comparatively smaller than roads in other parts of Europe. Number 11. Car insurance is very expensive. That's how it works in the UK. You cannot drive a car in Britain if you're not insured. You insure not just the car, but also the driver of the car. You know what that means? You don't have a car, and you have to use your friend's car as a licensed driver. You've also got to ensure that your driving insurance is still valid. Otherwise, you have to buy insurance even if you are using the car for just 2 days. Number 12. You need a license to watch TV. It may piss you off to have to pay for what they call the TV license to watch the TV you bought with your hard-earned money. Yes, unlike what obtains in some other countries where you get a few channels, you can get a whole range of TV channels in Britain. But if you watch your TV without buying a license, you're watching it illegally. Number 13. Inequality. As much as the government of the UK is talking about leveling up, inequality is still everywhere in Britain, and this is the dark side of living in the UK. The income inequality level is very high compared to other developed countries. It's also there in access to healthcare, even though it's better than what obtains in many other countries. There are other dark sides that other people will consider good sides, however, it depends on how you view it. If you love this video, please let us know in the comment section below. Kindly remember to subscribe to my channel. Please let me know how you feel about the pros and cons of what I mentioned here, or tell us your own dark side of living in Britain.